morning. It's Palm Sunday. And today we're going to hear a little bit about my friend the donkey and Jesus. Isn't that fabulous? Well, in today's scripture, we hear about Jesus coming into Jerusalem and he's being greeted by crowds of people shouting his praise and waving palm branches. All the while, Jesus is riding on the back of a very sweet little donkey. A donkey, you might say. Yep, a donkey. Donkeys are sweet, important, wonderful, and lovable creatures. They work hard and they provide transportation, even now, to people, like they did for Jesus. And sometimes they carry stuff. Sometimes really heavy stuff that people need. And there's something else about donkeys that's wonderful. Did you know that almost all donkeys have the mark of the cross on their backs? Yep, let me show you a picture. See that? It's the cross on the donkey's back. And see, even little ones have the cross on their backs. Isn't that awesome? Well, the story goes that the donkey that carried Jesus into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday loved him so much that he refused to leave his side. And when Jesus was dying on the cross, the donkey just couldn't bear to watch it. So he turned away. And when the sun shone down on the cross, it made the shadow of the cross on the donkey's back. And that mark stayed there forever on that little donkey and for all of his kind, even now. Now, the Bible only tells us about the donkey being with Jesus on Palm Sunday, but having met some donkeys and knowing how loyal and loving they are, oh my, it's not surprising to me that a donkey would not want to leave Jesus. But people aren't like donkeys in that way. We don't have Jesus's cross marked on us. It's not in our hair or on our skin, right? But some people do wear crosses, like me. And that helps to remind us of what Jesus did on that sad Good Friday long ago, because it's important to live in this truth. Jesus came to Jerusalem on the back of a donkey, and he came for all of the celebrating people there and for all people across all time to die, to be punished for bad things that he never did, so that we wouldn't have to be punished for the bad things that we do. So that we could be set free from all the mistakes we make and the things that we've done and the things that we will do. On that Palm Sunday, Jesus was celebrated and praised by crowds. But Jesus knew in a matter of days, the same people that were celebrating him would turn against him, and that he would be crucified on the cross, and that he would die. And he still came because he loved them, because he loves us, because he loves you. And that is really, really awesome news for the day. So are you ready to pray? It's a repeat after me prayer. Let's go. Dear God, thank you for Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for taking away my sins. Thank you for loving me. Help me to remember what you did for me always. And help me be more like you. And all God's children, that's all y'all, said, amen. Praise Jesus, children.